And a little stormy, a little rainy, but that's all right. God is still good. Amen.
Amen.
And we need the rain. We need the whatever the Lord sees fit to bring forth. Amen. Take it. Good to see you tonight in the house of the Lord. I think Jackson and them working a wreck or something. Working a wreck, so they may be sliding in here in a little bit. But we're here. We're going to worship the Lord and praise the Lord and have a good time tonight. And glad to see you here tonight. If you're visiting, we welcome you to the house of the Lord. Just make yourself at home. And we just like to have a good time. Amen?
Amen.
Good time in the Lord. You know, the Bible says the joy of the Lord is our strength. And I'm so glad I've got that joy way down deep. And that joy just swells up and keeps you going day to day. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's stand all over the building. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. And we're going to open up the service tonight with prayer. And whatever needs you have, just lift them to the Lord. We're thankful for the service this morning. We praise God for His power moving in this place and doing great and mighty things. And I believe tonight He can do the same. Hallelujah. So we come to worship and lift His mighty name. And let's go to the Lord in prayer. Whatever you have need of tonight, you can take them before Him, before the throne of grace. You have confidence. He's your help in your time of need. He's got grace. He's got mercy. He can do whatever you need tonight. And the Bible says, Paul said in Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Hallelujah. He said all things. All things. So you know we hear testimonies and things. Well, I can't do this. I can't do that. No, we can't do nothing outside of Christ. But with Christ, we can do all things. He's able to give us the power and the ability to do whatever that He calls us to do. And tonight it's good to be back in God's house. Good to see you smiling faces. Boy, it's good to see smiling faces, isn't it?
Amen.
Hallelujah. In times of trouble, it's good to know that God's got some folks on His side. That through it all, we're going to smile, we're going to count it all joy, and we're just going to push through this thing in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come before You tonight in the mighty name of Your Son, Jesus. And we're so thankful, Lord, to be back in Your house tonight and to be able to feel Your presence and the power of the Holy Spirit that is here. We thank You for each one that has made the effort to come out to Your house tonight to worship You. And Lord, I know that You're going to honor that tonight. And Lord, we just want to lift up Your name. We just want to praise You and worship You tonight and give You adoration because You and You alone is worthy. And God, we thank You for the service this morning that You gave us. We thank You for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit and the power that came down from on high, Lord, and moved in this place. And Lord, we never want to take it for granted. We just always want to be a thankful people. And Lord, tonight we ask You to move in this place. And God, You would open the windows of heaven and pour out upon us tonight. And God, we just want to step into that water, step into that river as it flows, God. And Lord, move upon us tonight in a mighty way. And we ask You to need that's in this house tonight. Lord, move upon every family, upon every home, every need that needs to be met. God, we pray that You meet that need tonight. And God, we ask You, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, we ask You to lead, guide, direct this service. And Lord, we ask most of all that Your anointing be upon us tonight in this place. And we ask it all in Jesus' mighty name and all God's people said.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Let's give the Lord. But if you came tonight, let's stand there. I always, you know, my daddy always told people they sung better when they stood up.
Amen.
I don't know how Amen. True that is because you couldn't hardly pay much attention to much he said. But anyway, praise the Lord. Let's sing tonight from our hearts to the Lord and praise. Glory to God.
Oh,
Praise the Lord. How many looking forward to heaven one day? Amen. Praise the Lord. What's your name left? Y'all got another one? Songs in the song book. One of these days we're going to be there in that great jubilee. Hallelujah. And it's going to be a time of never-ending joy and forever after. Hallelujah. What a time it'll be. Sing it. Shout it. Praise it. Amen. Let's sing it like we mean it tonight.
In the sky.
choice tonight for Brother Teddy to do that song. He testified, in case nobody see it the other night, Brother Teddy joined back here at the church the other night at Grace Union, and he has been on fire for the Lord, and I didn't know he sung until the other night, but he's going to sing tonight.
Not well.
Oh, well. It's in the spirit. It was good. And tonight he's going to sing that song, The Lighthouse. Boy, don't Amen. You love that old song? I just want to have me thankful for that lighthouse tonight.
Amen.
If it wasn't for that lighthouse, this old ship would be no more. Amen. Yep. Give Brother Teddy a big hand as he sings tonight. Praise the Lord. That is, I tell you, there's nothing. nothing like Jesus tonight. Amen. Amen. Nobody like you. Hallelujah. Casey, if you would get ready to sing that song here in just a few minutes. And I just want to share a quick word from the Lord tonight. I don't want to hold you very long. But we want to minister tonight for just a few moments. Aren't you glad for that lighthouse?
Amen. Amen.
Aren't you glad for Jesus tonight? And you know, Brother Terry, I met a lot of folks, a lot of old friends that said, you know, you ought to just tear that old lighthouse down. You ought to just forget about that thing. That old thing, you know, it's out of date. And, you know, sometimes it seems like folks think that it don't work. But I tell you what, that lighthouse is still standing on the hill. Hallelujah. And it's still a help to those that look for that light. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness on this place tonight? Come on. Hallelujah. It's all right for praising. It's all right. That light still stands up on that hill, the lighthouse. And I'm glad when my ship was out there on the rocks of sin, glory to God, when it looked like that it was getting ready to sink, I'm glad Jesus showed up and that light just passed by one Sunday morning. And I hadn't been the same since. Amen. Amen. Aren't you glad for His saving power? I wish I had a talk to you. Hallelujah. Praise God. He still stands up on that hill. Turn with me in your Bible to James chapter 5 for just a few moments. James chapter 5. And we're going to have just a few moments tonight. We're going to have a call to prayer. And we're going to come around this altar and we're going to pray. And I mean, we're going to pray in the Spirit. We're going to pray in the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. How many knows the church tonight needs a prayer meeting? Glory to God, we get tired, we get wore out, but we need a prayer meeting to revive us. Hallelujah. And so tonight we're going to have just a time of prayer. We're going to gather around this altar. We're going to lay out before the Lord every need that we have. And when we do, we're going to lay it there and leave it and not pick it up. We're going to leave it in the hands of the Lord. Now you can be quiet if you want to. I'm going to preach anyway for just a few moments.
Amen.
Did I come to grace you tonight?
Amen.
I did, but anyway, so, all right. Turn with me to James chapter 5. Stand with me, the honor and reverence, reading God's word. Hallelujah. James chapter 5, verse 16. Let me go back to verse 14. Let me go back to verse 13. Here in a minute, we'll be all the way back to the beginning of the book of James.
Amen.
I just think keep looking better and better every time I look at it. Okay. The Bible says in verse 13, is any among you afflicted? Is any among you afflicted? That word afflicted means suffering. Suffering. Is any among you suffering? And then the Bible says, let him pray. That's where we fail a lot of times when we are suffering and we're afflicted and we have troubles and trials and they weigh us down. And a lot of times the last thing on our mind to do is pray.
Amen.
Let him pray. Is any merry, let him sing songs. And that's what we do around here. When we get merry, we get happy, we get joyful. What do? We sing.
Praise Amen. Amen.
Anyway, verse 14, is any sick among you? Now, in the original translation, this is not a question. It's a statement. There are some among you that is sick. It's not asked in the Greek translation. It says that there is someone that is sick among you. And so we have to understand we're not exempt from sickness tonight.
Right.
Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. But there's a cure for it. There's a remedy for it. It's called prayer.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So is any sick among you, let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And here's the cure. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick.
Amen.
In other words, the prayer of faith shall restore the sick. Hallelujah. Now the Bible says, and the Lord shall raise him up. He won't think about it. It won't be a maybe thing, but the Lord will raise him up. And if he have committed sins, they shall be forgiven him. Now, it's not the case every time, but sometimes sickness is the result of sin. It's not that case every time, but sometimes it is. Sometimes time sickness comes because of some sin in our life. But the Bible says, confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that you may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much.
Amen.
Now, verse 17 says, Elijah was a man subject to like passions as we are. That was his nature. He was a man just like we are, normal human being. And the Bible says that he prayed earnestly that it might not rain. And it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again. And the heaven gave rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Aren't you glad of that tonight?
Amen.
And Lord, we come before you once again in the mighty name of Jesus. And we thank you and we praise you tonight for your mighty word. We thank you, God, tonight that we have your word to lean on. And Lord, we praise you, God, that there's never failed one word of all your good promise. And Lord, you are faithful tonight. And you can do, Lord, miracles and wonders. And we thank you for that tonight. And our faith is completely in you, and our trust is completely in you. And we're asking you tonight, Lord, that you would anoint this word. And God, as we come together to pray tonight, that Lord, the mighty power of the Holy Spirit would begin to move amongst us in our midst. And he would begin to move upon every need and every sickness and every affliction, Lord, tonight. And God, we praise you and thank you for it. And we ask it in Jesus' mighty name, and all God's people said,
amen.
Amen and amen. The Bible tells us in the book of James chapter 5, you may be seated. The Bible tells us in James chapter 5 that Elijah was a man of like passions like we are. He was a normal human being just like me and you. We sometimes look at these men and women in the Bible like they're heroes and things, and they are. But we have to remember a lot of times that they are just men and women like you and me. And Elijah, there was something about Elijah that he had inside of him. His ministry was something to behold. His ministry was amazing. But Elijah was a praying man.
Amen.
And we ought to be praying men and women today. You know, there is one source that we have that moves the hand of God, and it is prayer. And when a church ceases to pray and an individual ceases to pray, they have cut off the source of strength and the source of power that there is, that God has available for the Christian tonight. That's why we got to keep on praying. We got to keep on pressing in prayer. As a matter of fact, prayer like never before. You see, prayer bends the ear of God, but it's our faith, praying in faith, believing. Sometimes we pray not even believing what we're praying for, but when you pray in faith, believing, God will do it. Hallelujah, that faith moves the hand of God, and miracles will happen. Sicknesses will be cured. Diseases will be cured. I wish I could get a witness of that
prayer
to anybody here tonight. Hallelujah, prayer changes things.
Amen.
Glory, do we believe that or not?
Yes.
Hallelujah, prayer changes things. And the Bible said Elijah was a man, he was just a natural man like us. But he had the source. There was a power that he had within him. You and I have tonight. And the Bible says that he prayed for it not to rain. And it didn't rain. Then he prayed for it to rain. And then it rained. I'm telling
Amen.
You tonight, the same God Elijah served, that same source Elijah had, that same strength Elijah had, don't think that it's diminished. Don't think that it's went anywhere. That same source is here tonight. That same source is available to us tonight. We can pray and God will make it happen. Can
Amen.
You say
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, you know, he said the effectual prayer. Effectual means effective. It means, that word effective means to be active. We've got to be active in our prayer life. You know that? We ought to not cease to pray ever. Hallelujah. We pray without ceasing. Never stop praying. We don't gauge on how much we pray or when we pray or how we pray by what's going on around us. We pray anyway. We pray no matter what, because we pray not just because it seems seems like something good to do. We pray because we know we're praying to a God that can, a God who can change the situation, a God who can change the circumstance. How many believes that tonight?
Amen.
Means to be active. It means, it's a Greek word, effectual, that means to be mighty in power, to produce an effect. This would mean an effective supplication, that when we're praying, we're not just praying words, we're not just saying things, but our prayers are powerful. Our prayers are effective in the ears of God. Our prayers are effectual, and the effectual prayers, that's what changes things. When we're active in our prayers. Hallelujah. When we send up an effective supplication to the Lord, God hears it. And when we mean business with Him, He means business with us. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. The effectual fervent prayers of a righteous man availeth much. That word availeth means accomplishes. It accomplishes. It prevails. It's the ability to acquire strength and power to prevail, especially over the enemy, because we've got an enemy tonight that would love to destroy us. But I'm here to tell you, the effectual fervent prayers of righteous men and women is what's going to bring us through this storm. It's what's going to bring us through this trial. It's what's going to bring us through these valleys. It's what's going to take us across these rivers. I'm talking about an effectual, fervent prayer. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And then he uses the word earnestly. And sometimes I think we leave that word earnestly out. That earnestly means that's an action. It's the act of showing to God your seriousness. You know,
amen.
I think about Peter, who was locked up down there in prison. And they took him in and they locked him to the floor. But the Bible says while he was down there in the prison house, meanwhile the church was praying. I wonder sometimes how many of us, we see people in trouble. We see people facing battles that's intense and heated. How many of us sometimes we would get down and pray for? I know here we got some praying folks that I'm talking about all over. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. The enemy won't do that. The enemy will drive you deeper and down into the ground and try to beat you down and try to get you where you're not motivated to live for the Lord. But what I'm telling you is tonight, while the church is praying, hallelujah, things can happen, glory to God. Prayer moves the hand of God. And when you have prayer, prayer meeting shakes the house where you're in. Have you ever been in a house shaking prayer meeting?
Amen.
I'll never forget one time, and I'm getting ready. We get ready to have prayer, but I'll never forget one time up in Campbellsville at the hospital. There was a friend of mine. He was pastor of a church in Jamestown at that time. His colon had bursted and he was laying there practically on his deathbed. The nurses and doctors said, and they said it was just a matter of just him passing on. But he, you know, they had Bible study on Tuesday nights. So they asked me if I would come up and lead the church service at the chapel at the hospital. I said, I'd be honored to. We went up there. We got in that chapel. We had service in the middle of that hospital, and I gave them the word that God had gave me to deliver that night. And then we got down, and I don't know, that may have been 50 people that had filled that little chapel we was in. And you know, we got down there and we had prayer meeting. I said, what we need to do, I said, I know the doctors have said he's on his deathbed. I know the doctors have said it won't be long. Hallelujah. But I believe God's report tonight. I said, we're going to get down, we're going to pray. And you know, I am not kidding you, literally we got down in that floor prayer. I'll never forget, I was over next to a wall, and that wall was like a brick wall. And I can remember while the people were in there praying. Now these people were Holy Ghost filled people that were praying. They didn't just kind of softly pray, which is nothing wrong with that. But I'm talking about these people cut loose. They didn't care who was around. They didn't care what anybody thought about them. They didn't care what the nurses thought. They didn't care what the cafeteria workers thought. They were just trying to get a hold of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And I'm taking to the church decides it's important enough to get a hold of God and earnestly pray, fervently pray. Hallelujah. Sending your petitions up to the Lord. Don't expect miracles to happen. But let me tell you, when the church begins to pray, Peter's chains fell off at night and God released him out of his prison. And he showed back up at the house where they were praying. And a little servant girl named Rhoda came and answered the door. And you know what? I don't know what they were in there praying, but obviously they didn't even believe what they were praying.
Yeah.
I don't know if they were praying for Peter to be released or if God would just give Peter comfort while he's down in that prison. I don't know what they were praying, but I just know they were praying. And the Bible said when Peter got to that house, Rhoda opened up the door, she thought she'd seen a ghost.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes we pray, don't even believe what we're praying. Hallelujah. Sometimes we put a time limit on God when we're praying and we get around the altar, we pray, we see somebody get up, go to the seat. We think, well, it's time for us all to get up and go to the seat. But let me tell you something. We need a prayer meeting where we can pray through.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray through. And I believe there's just enough folk here. I believe prayer can move the hand of God right here in this building tonight. How many would believe that?
Amen.
How many would really believe that?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says in 1 John 3:22, whatsoever we ask, we receive of him because we keep his commandments. That means we keep his word and we do those things that are pleasing in his sight. Mark 11:24, Jesus said, I say unto you, what things soever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. Now there's a catch here to that scripture, because that's only when one seeks the real true desire of God. When you're praying and you're praying, your heart's lined up with God's heart and you're wholeheartedly serving him, dedicated to him, you'll want the things that God wants. Hallelujah. And you'll hate the things that God hates.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And so when we pray and we're seeking the desires of God, in other words, seeking his will, as some put it. Hallelujah. But the thing is, that sounds really good. But the most people that say, well, I'm praying for God's will. But the most people don't know what God's will is because they haven't studied his word. And it's God's will that we be in health and prosper in this life. That's what his word tells us. Hallelujah. And he may allow us to go through some things, but rest assured, if you keep holding on praying, he's going to bring you out.
Amen.
Glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. John 15:7, Jesus said, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will and it shall be done unto you. That tells me there is power in prayer tonight.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hebrews 11:6 says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he that comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You see, when we pray, we ought to be praying with an earnest expectation.
Yeah,
amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Let me say that one more time. When we pray, we ought to pray with an earnest expectation that God is going to do what we're asking him to do, as long as it lines up with his desires and his will. You see, Psalm 62, that the psalmist said, truly my soul waiteth upon God. From him cometh my salvation. He only is my rock and salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved. You got to get in that prayer place. You got to get in that prayer closet, not just in church, but when you're at home, when you're on the job, when you're riding down the road, you can pray to the Lord. His line is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You get up in the middle of the night, 2 o'clock in the morning, and something is bothering you. Aren't you glad while everybody else is in bed asleep and you got nobody to talk to? Aren't you glad there's one that's sitting on the throne in the heavens and you can call on him, call him up when you need him 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. His line is always open. That's why I say there's something that sets us apart from the world. We've got a direct line to the heavens, and his name is Jesus. Glory to God. And he will Praise God. Can you sing that song, Casey? I thought y'all be ready. Y'all can come out here and sit down. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. I'll tell you tonight, if you want victory, you can have it. If you want joy, you can have it. If you want peace, you can have it. Whatever you have need of, God has it for you, and He will bring it to you. Hallelujah. He's the God that can. He is able tonight. If you've got the faith to believe, He can do it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go ahead and sing that song, Victory Sweet. Hallelujah. Boy, it's good, isn't it? Hallelujah. Go ahead. Praise the Lord. While we're doing that, let's just gather around and pray tonight. Come on. Oh, well, let's gather around this altar, call to prayer. They can sing. And get all that, hallelujah. But let's come tonight before the Lord. Every need you have, every care, every burden you have tonight, this is the night to just release it, let it go, and let God take it, and He'll help you tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And your direction. We're thankful tonight that God, when it seems like there's nothing else or no one else to turn to, that God, we can come to you. And Lord, we just thank you tonight that you are all powerful. You are all sufficient. You are the God of mercy and the God of grace. You are the God that loves us and compassionate with us. And we're so grateful for that tonight. And Lord, we're sending up our petitions with thanksgiving, Lord. And Lord, we thank you tonight for salvation. We thank you, Lord, for deliverance. We thank you how you brought us out, Lord, from the place that we was. And Lord, you're taking us to that glorious place of the afterworld. And Lord, God, we're here in the spirit, and we're so thankful tonight that we're on your covers with you, Lord, and your Lord.
You fight with the victory. Lord, you break the us. And I'm so thankful for tonight, God. We love you, Lord, with all of our heart, soul, and mind, everything we have. And we ask you to bless this church, God, and this church family. And Lord, we just pray that the life of the Holy Spirit will just be at our lips, Lord. And we breathe life upon us, God. And Lord, we just praise you and worship you tonight. Lord, we know there is no God like you. And Lord, in such a wicked time we live in a time of darkness, Lord. Lord, we ask you that you would raise the church up, Lord. To be the light that city that set up the hill that cannot be hidden. That our light would so shine in the hill. That they would see our true worship glorify you, which is in heaven. Lord, we ask for all those that are sick tonight in body, that God, you would move upon them. I ask you to touch those with cancer, Lord. I pray, Lord, that a mighty healing will come upon them. I pray, Lord, for those that are stricken with diseases and things. I pray, Lord, tonight your mighty hand will move upon them. And your mighty healing power, virtue, will come upon their bodies. Lord, we need a touch of you in this place, Lord. And for this people, Lord, we need a touch of you. And God, the stripes of the stars opened up in us, Lord, to continue to serve you with all we got. Lord, we thank you for what you've done for us. You've been so good to us. And we're going to keep praying, Lord, in faith, believing. Because, Lord, we want to move to the mountains. And we praise you tonight. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
That don't face these battles, but they come to those that love the Lord and have wholeheartedly chosen to worship Him and follow Him in every step and follow His word. If you're not a threat to the kingdom of the devil, you're not going to face many battles from the Lord. But when you've got that fire shut up in your bones, you're going to face some battles. And Satan's going to try to hinder you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I think we got a roar back there. Brother Doug, roar. That's all right. Good to have a little roar every now and then.
Yeah.
Praise God. Somebody want to praise Him tonight?
I want to praise God for what I felt today. Yeah. And I want to praise Him for being with me on those mountains and in the valleys. He's helped me through many mountains.
Amen.
He's going to help me through some more too.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
I just thank you for saving me, for my church family, and I just thank you for everything.
Amen. Bless you, dear.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Somebody else want to just praise.
I thank the Lord for saving my soul, and I want to proclaim that my Lord is good.
Yeah.
He can do anything that you set that He sets His mind to.
Amen. Amen. You're right, Brother Mike. Praise the Lord. Somebody else. Praise the Lord. It has been a good day in the Lord.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise the Lord. You know, sometimes we get those places where we're so beat down by the troubles and everything around. We get so beat down to the ground. And we know in our mind we need to pray. We know, you know, it's not a matter that we don't know what to do. We know we need to pray. But we sometimes, once in a while, just don't feel like praying. And that's why I say it's not based on what we feel like. But have you ever been in those times where you didn't feel like praying? And the reason I'm asking is I've been there many times. And you're in a circumstance that looks dire. And you're in a place where you just don't know what to say or what to do or how to pray. But just the fact that you come before the Lord, you may not feel a thing. You may not even feel like you're saved anymore. But thank God it ain't based on feeling.
Amen.
It's based on the promises of the Word of God.
Amen.
And you know, just the fact that you can come to the Lord and say, Lord, I'm here and I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say. That's an act of faith. Do you know that?
Amen.
That's an act
Amen.
Of faith. Praise the Lord. And then that's when you've been in those places, and then that's when the Holy Spirit just begins to rise up in you. And then words begin to come out of your mouth that you didn't even think of. That's what Paul was saying in Romans 8, when we know not what to pray. That's when the Holy Spirit will begin to give utterances that the natural mind can't even comprehend. Why? Because the Holy Spirit knows how to pray.
Amen. Amen.
And He prays on our behalf.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Man, I tell you, it's been the shortest I've ever prayed, Brother Kenny. But it's all right then. Ain't no time.
Amen.
Amen. It's all right. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, that's all right.
Amen, brother.
That's it.
He will provide.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will. And I tell you, you can say these words, Lord, teach me to pray. And he'll do it. He'll do it. Glory to God. Boy, it feels so good in here. Margaret, what we do next? Did you get the program? You didn't hear it, did you? I don't know. They didn't hand it out today.
We've run out of paper.
Oh, man, it's getting the inflation. It's getting outrageous. We're trying to save the forest.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Every heart twinkling.
I've got to thank the Lord tonight.
Yeah.
I thank my soul and why I felt here tonight.
Yeah.
He's bringing me out of the valley right now.
Yeah.
I'm climbing that mountain. I can't wait to get to the top.
Amen. Yeah. Going Christian.
Amen.
Taking me to the top because I don't want to get there.
Amen.
I have a little more faith.
Amen. I tell you, I believe Brother Teddy's going to be all right, don't you?
Amen.
I believe he is.
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. Bless you, Jackie. Love you. Hallelujah. Jackie's going through a tough time right now, but we're going to continue lifting her up in prayer. God will strengthen her. He'll work a miracle. I believe he will. He's still a God of miracles.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Are you an A-flat? Let's do this little chorus, and then we'll be dismissed. And after we get done singing this, hug somebody tonight, tell somebody you love them. You don't know, this may be the very last time that we're gathered like this together. This may be the last time you see the one sitting next to you, sitting in this place. Life is a vapor, here today, gone tomorrow. You don't know what may. People say, well, you're young, they tell me all the time. I say, yeah, but death is no respect to age.
That's right.
You can be a teenager. And God's appointed time for you has come, and you're out of here. And so we never may see each other again. You never know on this side of the grave. So tonight we get done with this song. You tell somebody you love them tonight, love their name. And I think we'll do this song. This is just
it.
Well, what a mighty God is heard. Oh, believe that, give the Lord a big praise. You better know that they can't go ahead and that good part tonight. Let somebody come to 11 Wednesday night, Bible study, 6:30, be here with us. We're going to have a great time, Lord. We'll be starting in the book of Colossians Wednesday night. So love each and every one of you. God bless you.
All right.